Hey guys, as always, thanks for stopping by. For a couple months, Virginia has been ground zero in the fight for our freedom, but today, we're gonna head out west coming up. Today is brought to you by the Shooting Tripod. Y'all see me use it. It's the Death Grip by Bog. It's solid, and it's on Amazon right now with free shipping. I'll put a link right down below. Hey, I got two for you. Let me get through New Mexico first, and then we'll get out to the whopper of Arizona. Well, it's another bad one. A few days ago, the New Mexico State Senate, they passed SB 5. It's a red flag bill that passed with a narrow margin, 22-4 and 20 against. The bill allows law enforcement to take firearms away from individuals in the state who are deemed a danger to themselves or others. I'll put a link to the bill's current version right down below. Now, the bill will go to the House next, which has a Democratic majority, and it's likely going to pass there. And then it's going to hit the governor's desk. Now, she backs the proposed law, so it looks like it's going to make it through. They're going to have to do it fast. There's only about 12 days left in the current session. Now, two things in all of this that I want you to take note of. First, according to KOAT Channel 7 in Albuquerque, they report that a majority of the sheriffs in the state do not support the red flag law. So we'll see if they enforce it. And second, all 70 seats in the New Mexico House of Representatives, they're up for re-election this year or up for election. And if the people in the land of enchantment stand up for the Constitution, it could be a bloodbath. So we'll see. Okay, let's head a little bit west. Arizona, whoo boy, without exaggeration, this bill is quite literally as bad of a bill as possible, and it makes Virginia look like a slumber party of happiness in comparison. Senate Bill 1625 has been introduced and has had its second reading to the state Senate. Now, the bill was sponsored by 12 anti-Constitution Democrats. I'll put their names right up here for you to see, and I'm going to put a link right down below to the actual bill itself. I know some of you guys and gals read all of them, but this one isn't too long, and even if reading bills is not your thing, I do encourage you to go through this one yourself in black and white. See it for yourself, what these leftists are trying to do to our country. Senate Bill 1625 is, and we're not going to argue about this one down in the comment section, not today. I'm not asking you on this one, I'm telling you, it is a clear attempt to disarm the population. Now, I won't go through the entire bill, but the first line is, quote, a person, corporation, or other entity may not manufacture, import, possess, purchase, sell, or transfer any assault weapon or large capacity magazine, close quote. Now, this bill does allow citizens to keep their weapons if they register them with the state. Otherwise, they have to render them inoperable, move the guns out of state, or surrender them to authorities. And if the bill passes, folks will have 90 days to comply or they will become a felon. Now, the bill does outlaw semi-automatic and some other shotguns. And some folks are saying that it also includes pistols as well. Yeah, of course it includes semi-automatic pistols and centerfire pistols, AR pistols, that kind. But some folks are saying that it also includes regular pistols like Glocks. I can't find that in the bill. As I read it, 1625 is all about assault weapons, centerfire, and magazines over 10 rounds plus the shotgun stuff. Now, I can't believe what I'm about to say, but we are talking about gun registration with a background check and yearly for life having to re-register or renew the registration and submit to a yearly background check over and over. And all of this, of course, would be more out-of-pocket money and hassle and time for all of these folks. Why? So the government can sell citizens their own rights back to them. And get this, who is exempt from Bill 1625? Any guesses? Yep. Government employees, government agencies, and law enforcement. They, of course, get to keep their rifles, pistols, and magazines. Oh, and there are more. I haven't seen anyone else talk about this yet, but as I read the bill, Section H says, quote, the registered owner of an assault weapon may not purchase additional assault weapons, close quote, close quote. But Sometimes it's not really clear. I don't know why my hands are up here today, but I'm praying apparently we need to. It's not always clear with the nuances of reading these bills. I'm a layperson, and I know sometimes it's a struggle, but as I read it, and again, I encourage you to go check it out right down below. Check it out for yourself. It looks like after the law is passed, if you register your firearms, you cannot purchase another AR. Hey, if any of y'all got more clarification on Section H, can you let me know down below? I would like more on that. Now, everybody take a deep breath. The good news is that the Arizona Republicans currently hold the Senate and the House. Well, that's good news because I assume that the Republicans won't vote to shred the Constitution. But as we all know, sometimes Republicans can cross over and vote with the Democrats. Mitt Romney. Usually at this point, I offer you some commentary. I don't think I need to with this one. The bill is anti-American garbage. Now, moving forward, what I'm going to do is pay close attention to everything coming out of both New Mexico and Arizona, and I'll keep you up to date. Hey, if you think I've earned it, do you mind giving me a thumbs up right down there? That really is a big help to me. Thanks for that. Hey, I'm Johnny. Let freedom ring. Bye.